Tonight, the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences presents its annual Grammy Awards for artistry and excellence in the field of recorded entertainment of the past year. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, John Denver.
Biggest night in music, and we're here live in Los Angeles with a show that's so hot it's gonna pop if we don't get right into it. This has been an amazing year for women in the music business. So right now we're gonna start with a woman who's already won for Best Inspirational Performance tonight, Miss Donna Summer. And here she is with a group of ladies who promise to work hard for the money.
Grammy Award, Ernest Dean Anderson, The Beach Boys, Chuck Berry, Big Country, Irene Cara, Kim Carnes, Alice Cooper, Culture Club, Rodney Dangerfield, Bill Bristow, Bob Dylan, Sheena Easton, Eurythmics, Floyd the Muppet featuring Jerry Nelson, Ginny Fricke, Al Green, Herbie Hancock, Julio Iglesias, James Ingram, Al Jarreau, Grace Jones, Quincy Jones, Gladys Knight, the cast of La Caja Ball, Cindy Lauper, Melissa Manchester, Quentin Marsalis, Michael McDonald, Christine McVie, Menudo, Ann Miller, Ann Murray, Oak Ridge Boys, Pentecostal Community Choir, Michelle Pilar, Joan Rivers, Linda Ronstadt, Nikki Rooney, Bob Seger, Richard Stoltzman, Donna Summer, George Thorogood, Toto, Bonnie Tyler, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Albertino Walker, B. Wayville, Joe Williams, and Stevie Wonder. This portion of the 26th.
Welcome to the 26th Annual Grammy Awards, the show that celebrates all of America's music. Pop, rock, jazz, classical, all the music we listen to and all the music we love. Tonight we honor the nominees and their recordings selected by the peers, the members of the Recording Academy. The big words this past year were video, Boy George, and Michael. And of course, as we said earlier, the tremendous success that a lot of women in music have had over the past year. To reflect that, instead of just presenting one nomination this evening from the pop female category, we've asked all five nominees to perform for you this evening. How'd you like to see Bonnie Tyler, Sheena Easton, Irene Cara, Linda Ronstadt, along with Donna Summer, all in one show? That's kind of what I thought. Well, throughout the evening, we'll be announcing some of the Grammy Awards that were given earlier, just before we went on the air. And now let's get to the awards. To present our first award of the evening for Best New Song of the Year, here are two great, great songwriters, Mr. Bob Dylan, Mr. Stevie Wonder.
Y'all better stop that. You're making us feel like we're stars. Hello? Okay. This is a very exciting category, as you know, because this is the one that has solely been designated for those writers whose song will be nominated as Song of the Year. Now, there are five songs, and of course, you know, only one can win. But I think, and I'm sure, Bob, you feel the same way, that just being nominated in itself is an honor. So, you got it.
The nominees are...
Everyone you meet, they're damning it for me.
All Night Long. Line number
two. Letter Ritchie, right? Michael Jackson, songwriter.
Billie Jean. Billie Jean, Michael Jackson.
Every breath you take, Sting, by the
way. Maniac.
Michael Cimbello.
Dennis Mankowski.
And the winner is, you know what? Hold on, let's just forget all that stuff. You know what? Every year the same old thing happens, right? And the winner is, but this time we're gonna do something different and unique and special. Okay, in the 80s, this is the 80s, right? So, what we wanna do is we wanna get you all here to decide. Is it? Song number one, number two, number three, four, or five. You all say, which one is it?
got to do it the old-fashioned way.
Let me look at that. Let me see that. She got it back up. Every breath you take.
Sting's not here tonight. He's in
Australia. We'll take the award with us.
Touring, but we'll take it, yeah.
Congratulations to you, Sting.
In recent years, artists like Pat Benatar, John Cougar, Rick Springfield, The Police, Bob Seger, Bob Dylan, and Billy Joel have won Grammys in the rock categories. We now have a new kind of rock that stirs the senses visually as well as audibly. When this new group soared into prominence in the United Kingdom this past year, it meant a lot to the young gentlemen involved. It meant the sense of satisfaction that comes with progress through hard work and determination and original talent. To fans of rock music, it meant the excitement of seeing a brand new group just beginning to peak. Nominated for Best Rock Performance by Duo or Group with Vocal, as well as for Best New Artist, here's the spirited Big Country.
Big country dreams, stay with you like a lover's voice.
two presenters proved that you don't have to be strange or different to be successful. But don't tell them about it. They've separately carved careers for themselves because they refuse to be anything other than exactly what they are. One of them has just released his 17th album in what he calls his continuing collection of inventive short stories in sound. The other is truly one of rock's most provocative performers, known to many as the secret night goddess of Gotham. She has joined together the influences of Jamaican reggae, English rock, and the European sound, made it all her very own. Anytime you think the music business is getting too predictable, just think of these two names. Ladies and gentlemen, Alice Cooper and Miss Grace Jones.
Before we give out this award, don't you think we should tell the folks about some of the other people who won Grammys in rock earlier tonight?
Yes, there was Love is a Battlefield, Pat Benatar for Best Rock Vocal Performance for a Female, and
Beat It,
Michael Jackson for Best Rock Vocal Performance Male. Brimstone and Trickle.
No, Brimstone and Trickle.
Trickle.
By
Sting.
For Best Rock Instrumental Performance.
Right.
And now the nominations for the Best Rock Performance by a Duo or Group with Vocal. They are Talking Heads.
Easy Top, Eliminator.
Synchronicity. And the winner is Tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't want to have this done.
Synchronicity, The Police.
The Police could not be here tonight, but they're on tour in New Zealand, and we congratulate them on the award. They're in New Zealand. While she was growing up in Swansea in South Wales in the 60s, she listened to the music of the Beatles and the Dave Clark Five, always hoping that someday she'd be on the radio. And it wasn't long after that that people began to notice what an amazing voice she had and that it should be on record. In 1978, she received international attention with a haunting version of It's a Heartache. And now, 5 years later, she's back with one of the most riveting ballads of the year, turning her heartache into a total eclipse of the heart. Nominated for Best Pop Female Vocal Performance, here's Bonnie Tyler.
26th annual.
Far into the show, there's one bit of business that we have to get settled. That's, of course, the rules. And to do just that, we have a unique way of accomplishing it tonight. We go by satellite to London, England, and two of the hottest names in the business today. Here are Joan Rivers and Culture Club. Take it away, London.
Hello. Greetings from London, and can we talk?
Do we have a stop?
No, not when I'm with you. Please introduce the whole group.
It's John, yeah. Roy, and Mikey. Hello. Very sexy.
Hello. Yes.
Fab.
Now, you, everyone knows, is known as Boy George, so you can just call me Girl Joan.
Okay, Joan.
Or, in my case, Boy Joan.
Okay. It's a fab dress, you look like Grace Jones.
Thank you very
on
much.
On steroids.
And you look like Brooke Shields on steroids. May I just say before we go on, George and the group belong here, but I am thrilled to be on a music show because I know very little about music. I thought the song Say, Say, Say was Mel Tillis trying to do the national anthem. So, I think we should get to the rules. Do you want to read the rules or shall I read the rules?
Okay, I'll read the rules.
I think
they're very complicated.
We are the perfect people to read the rules, don't you think? Because we are both rule breakers.
Okay.
I know. And I think the reason that we should read the rules is mainly because every one of the nominees out there should know exactly why they lost out to Michael Jackson, okay?
Thatcher's the name, and rules are my game.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's humor like that that lost you India.
Thank you.
Would you do the rules?
Okay. Each year, the Recording Academy's voting members recommend recordings that they feel are worth a Grammy Award. These initial entries are screened because they're eligible and submitted to the active member who selects the final nomination. Another round of voting by this membership determines the real results, and these results are not known until the envelopes are opened on stage tonight. Tabulation and guarding of these envelopes is strictly the responsibility of the independent accounting firm of...
Deloitte, Haskins,
and Sells.
I've had them all. Oh. Great accountants, but not so good. I'm telling you that. Before we go, we did want to say seriously that we're very thrilled to be part of the Emmys.
We're very thrilled, but can you turn down the color of my face? I look pink.
No, we are thrilled to be part of the Grammys, and we wish all of you great good luck out there. And we all were talking beforehand.
We all hope you win, yes, as well. We hope you win.
Oh, it's very hard for those that don't win. And you shouldn't all think that Michael Jackson is going to get it, because Michael Jackson may not get everything. Many of you are up for things. We hope somebody else gets it with Michael, as well as Michael. And just one more thing, though. Just in case, Tito, please, back up the truck.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and back to you, Joan.
Thank you very much, Joan. And thank you, Boy George and Culture Club. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is a representative of the firm Deloitte, Haskins & Sells, my good friend, Mr. Thomas Shepard. Prior to just a couple of years ago, video music was non-existent. Since then, it has forged ahead to revitalize and totally reawaken the music industry. The dramatic images projected by these videos clearly tell a story that informs, excites, and entertains us. The Recording Academy is proud to recognize achievements in commercially released video music. The first Video Grammy was awarded 2 years ago. And here to present this year's Video Album Award is a lady who won a Grammy this year, whose Betty Davis Eyes was Record of the Year in 1981. With her as one of last year's nominees, who says he's got a job with his band only because he was the guy that had a car that could drag all the instruments to the gigs. Here are Miss Kim Carnes and the lead singer of the Tubes, Fee Waybill.
Before we start, I'd like to congratulate Kim on winning a Grammy before the telecast started on TV tonight.
Thanks.
For Flashdance.
They wouldn't let me keep it, though. They took it away. They took it. Thanks. If the past year proved anything in music, it proved that the future was being shaped by the creative people who began a new art form, video music. It's an exciting new medium, and it's just a beginning.
That's right. Its beginnings can be traced to earlier innovators like the Beatles and their fascinating images, created to satisfy a public that would rarely get to see them live.
It continued through the 70s, when groups whose visual presence was as strong as the music, they took the next steps. Before we present the award for the best video album, we'd like to congratulate Girls on Film, Hungry Like the Wolf, Duran Duran, for winning the best video short form, which is 20 minutes or less.
And now, the nominees for the best video album are... Cooper, The Nightmare, Alice Cooper. The one-man show, Grace Jones. Spend the night together, the Rolling Stones. And the video album of the year 1984 is Duran Duran. Duran Duran is not here tonight. They are touring the East Coast. We congratulate them on behalf of us and all of you. Thank you very much and good night.
Thanks.
The Lifetime Achievement Award is voted on by the Recording Academy Board of Trustees and is given to an individual not just for a specific recording or song, but for a lifetime of honored work. The three gentlemen we honor this evening have affected our enjoyment of music in three distinctive ways. Our first award is presented posthumously to the man who was and will always be known affectionately as the Maestro, Arturo Toscanini. Born in Parma, Italy, 10 years before the invention of the phonograph, he made his American debut in 1908. He was prominent conductor of the New York Philharmonic from 1927 until 1936. In 1937, the NBC Symphony was created for him. He led that orchestra until his retirement in 1954. He remains a legend in the world of classical music 25 years after his death. Our second honoree is a jazz innovator. He is the bird, Charlie Parker. And like a bird, he soared to heights of inspiration which ushered in a new era of jazz improvisation that influences both jazz and pop artists to this day. His recording career spanned a brief 14 years, but his impact is timeless. His recordings with Dizzy Gillespie and other jazz greats are classics which music lovers will always cherish. We're especially happy when we have the opportunity to honor someone during their lifetime. I'm delighted that our third recipient honored is here with us to celebrate his contribution to the world of recorded music. If rock and roll has a national anthem, I would say it's the first four bars of any guitar lick he ever played. It seems that at one time or another, the repertoire of every rock musician has included one of his songs. Johnny B. Good, Maybelline, Sweet Little 16, No Particular Place to Go, My Ding-a-Ling, Roll Over Beethoven, Rock and Roll Music, School Days. He has not just written and played rock and roll, he is without a doubt the father of rock and roll. He is, of course, the one and only Mr. Chuck Berry.
Singing in the sun, maybe coming when my work is all done. close my show now. I just can't play no more now. I really gotta go now. They done open the door now. Y'all want me to quit? Y'all want me to play? You don't want me to stop? You mean you want me to stay? Stay right here and boogie? Gotta go. Sure enough, I gotta go. Y'all gonna make me stay. Y'all gonna let me play. Stay right here and work. All night and all day. Get your hand up high. Get your hand up high. We gotta see your hand. Well, a little bit higher.
The studio musician is one of the most creative individuals in recording. If you're good, everybody wants you. Nobody can make the record they want without you. In the case of our next presenters, they went from being the most sought-after studio musicians in pop music to one of its most successful performing and recording groups. Last year, as a group and as individuals, they won 6 Grammys, including Record of the Year and Album of the Year, with songs like Rosanna and Africa. To present this year's Producer of the Year award is last year's Producer of the Year, ladies and gentlemen, Toto.
The nominees for Producer of the Year are James Anthony Carmichael and Lionel Richie. Jay Graydon.
Quincy Jones. Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson. And the Producer of the Year is...
Yeah, babe. Come on, what do you got? What are you looking at?
What do you got? Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson.
Yeah!
Michael, he made me promise if we won anything that I wouldn't pull my glasses out and embarrass him. Because he's 25 and I'm 50, you know what I mean? But the main job of a producer is to produce and see that everything works. And we'd like to thank the people that make this work. I'm not going to use my glasses, but I have to. We'd like to thank Paul McCartney, Eddie Van Halen, Vincent Price, Bruce Swedeen, Umberto Gatica, Don Landy, 62 musicians, the best in the world, 22 of the best singers in the world, the voters of NARIS, Epic Records, the disc jockeys, Freddie DeMann, Ron Weisner, the songwriters without whom we couldn't fly, Rod Temperton, Michael Jackson, James Ingram, Steve Picaro, John Bettis, my wife, who chose to take care of me rather than pursue her own career, and our family, and I love her, and Michael Jackson, his beautiful family. And I want to also thank him for co-producing Three to Sides on the album. And I think one of the greatest entertainers of the 20th century. I mean that from all my heart.
Take up much time. I just want to say thank you, and I love you all.
I am actually with the people now, and to present them with their Grandma Awards, which they have won from America, and they're delighted to be here this afternoon to receive them.
It's an honor, sir, to say the least.
Yeah. Eat, sir.
And it's nice to have a chance, really, isn't it?
Eat, sir.
Longua.
Longua.
Tuatip.
Tuatip.
Arrel.
Arrel.
It's a long way. Tuatip arrel.
20 years ago this month, the first British invasion took place on our shores. That is, if you don't count the Revolutionary War. The Beatles arrived, and soon to follow were groups like the Stones, the Yardbirds, the Animals, Herman's Hermits, the Dave Clark Five, and the list goes on and on and on. Now music is experiencing another wave of the invasion, a new wave with groups like Duran Duran, U2, The Clash, and Culture Club. What makes all of these groups distinctive is their ability to express musically and visually new and exciting ideas. What makes our next performers so special is the soulful and provocative voice of Annie Lennox, together with David Stewart's superb instrumental arranging. Their haunting sound of Sweet Dreams is representative of the kind of music that has made them so popular this year. Nominated for Best New Artist, ladies and gentlemen, the Eurythmics.
Sweet dreams are made of this. Who am I to disagree? Used by
You know, I could have sworn this afternoon or this morning in the dress rehearsal there was a redhead in that group. Now, what happens when you put together a girl who just wants to have a little fun and a fellow who just wants a little respect? Hopefully, we'll find out who'll be awarded the Grammy for the Best New Artist. Other than that, you never know. Here are Ms. Cyndi Lauper and rapping Rodney Dangerfield.
You know, hey, Cyndi, I really love your new record, you know. Girls just want to have fun.
Thanks, Rodney.
And I'll tell you, Cyndi, you know, boys want to have fun, too. You know what I mean?
Come on, Rodney. I told you backstage to leave me alone.
Now, look, you and I are over.
It never started, rock and roll animals.
You can forget about meeting Chevy Chase, too, okay?
Met him. For Best New Artist, the nominees are...
Between a woman and a boy. Between a child and a toy. For the falling of the rest. Before the journey of the rest.
To Tony and Abby Gordon and Gene at Wedge Music. Thank you all very much.
And also to Epic Records in America, and Susan Bland and everybody
and
there.
And also to Virgin Records in London, Ronnie Gurr and Simon.
And to the band.
Thank you, America. You've got taste, style, and you know a good drag queen when you see one.
Talking about me.
Grammy. We present the awards for gospel music in our show. The whole place kind of lights up. Something magical, maybe even a little mystical, starts to happen. I'm sure tonight will be no exception. Two vital performers from the world of gospel music are about to lighten our loads, lift the soul, stir your spirit. Our first performer left the world of rock music to become one of gospel's greats. He recorded one of Christian music's first contemporary albums at the age of 19. He's found a niche that's unique, with a hard-hitting vocal quality that comes from deep inside. Tonight, we're proud to present to you Mr. Phil Driscoll.
Love me, seven grace, how sweet the sound is to sing. Someone like me, once was lost, but now I've been found. Well, my eyes, they was blinded, oh, but now I can clearly see.
Made you whole. Bartimaeus received his sight. He praised God for the
Del Pilar, and Al Green.
Before we present the awards for the best male gospel performance, I think it would be a good idea to recognize tonight's winners of the gospel music. For the best gospel performance female, Ageless Melodies, Amy Grant. That's your part.
Okay, your turn.
For the best gospel performance by a duo or a group, More Than Wonderful, Sandy Patty, and Larnell Harris.
For best old gospel performance male, I'll Rise Again, Al Green. For best old gospel performance by a duo or group, I'm So Glad I'm Standing Here Today, Bobby Jones and Barbara Mandrell. For best inspirational performance, He's a Rebel, Donna Summer.
And now the Grammy for the best gospel performance male. The nominees are Dino for Chariots of Fire.
Phil Driscoll for I Exalt Thee.
Dion for I Put Away My Idols.
Michael W. Smith for Michael W. Smith Project.
Russ Taff for Walls of Glass.
And the winner is Walls of Glass, Russ Taff.
I'm very glad that 2,000 years ago Jesus died for me, and a lot of you know what I'm talking about. There's nothing I'd rather do in this world than to sing about him and to give this back to him. I want to thank Gary Whitlock, Stan Mosier from the record company at Word, Zach Glickman, Jack Quaig, and Bill Schnee, and Michael Omardian. God bless you all.
In the category of Best Soul Gospel Performance Female, the nominees are Tremaine Hawkins, Determined.
Albertina Walker, for God is able to carry you through.
Jesus, I love calling your name.
Candace Staten for Make Me an Instrument.
Vanessa Bell Armstrong, Peace Be Still.
And Sandra Crouch for We Sing Praise. And the winner is, oh, I get the biggie. You. Ooh-wee. I ain't gonna tell a soul. The winner is, we sang praises, Sandra Crouch.
I praise God for my music. I was looking around and look at the gifts that God has given all of us. It's so wonderful. And I'm so thankful because he gave me the music, he gave me the songs, and without him, I'm nothing. I thank my mother and my father and, of course, my twin brother Andre and my oldest brother and Ralph Carmichael and Light Records and Judy, my friend in Canada, and Diane.
She can talk. She thanks everybody.
Praise the Lord. God bless you.
The best pop female vocal performance started as a country folk singer in the 60s, turned to rock in the 70s, then expanded her musical horizons to include Broadway and the Pirates of Penzance. This past year, she went back to one of music's all-time staples, the standards. To arrange and conduct the album, she was wise enough to select a man who wears the title arranger and conductor with great honor. Ladies and gentlemen, here with one of the first artists to ever have won a Grammy, as well as one of tonight's winners, Mr. Nelson Riddle, is two-time Grammy winner, Miss Linda Ronstadt.
How glad the many millions of Toms and Dicks and Williams would be to capture me. But you had such persistence, you wore down my resistance. I fell, and it was swell. You're my big and brave and handsome Romeo. How I won you, I will never, never know. It's not that you're attractive, but oh, my heart grew active when you
since our next presenter scraped together enough money to make a demo record in their garage, put it out under the name of Carl and the Passions, and begin a career filled with honors, awards, and great success. You just have to mention songs like Fun, 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 Good Vibrations, I Get Around, and countless others to immediately identify them in the California sound that they created and gave to the whole world. I can only be talking about one group, ladies and gentlemen, the Beach Boys.
For Album of the Year, awards go to the artist and album producer. The nominations are Flashdance.
I'm going on a manhunt, turning around. Women have been hunted, now we're hunting around. Yeah, manhunt, we all got the need. The
Flashdance, original soundtrack in the motion picture. By Irene Cara, Shandy. Helen St. John, Karen Kamen, Joe Esposito, Laura Branigan, Donna Summer, Michael Five, Kim Carnes, Michael Sandeo, Giorgio Moroder, producer.
Oh, listen, boy, I'm sure that you think you got it all under control. You don't want somebody telling you the way to stay in someone's soul. You're a big boy now and you'll never let her go. The things she ought to know. Tell her.
An Innocent Man by Billy Joel, Bill Ramone.
Put on directions and dance the blues to the song.
Dance by David Bowie. David Bowie and Nile Rodgers, producer. By the Police. The Police and Hugh Padgett, producer.
Quincy Jones, producer, and the winner is, come on, Dan.
The winner is?
Oh, here we go.
There's no winner! Oh! Thriller!
It's a great honor. I'm very happy. I'd like to thank Epic Records, the best record company in the world. And the best... the best president of any record company, Walter Yetnikoff. Come up here, Walter. Where are you? Walter Yetnikoff, ladies and gentlemen.
A
I'm just as old as Quincy. I have glasses, too. I'd like to thank Merkel, whose album Thriller has sold more than any other album in the history of music. And to the artist, and to the man who has shown us the way in music, in youth, in song, and dance, and as a man. Michael, thank you.
Thank you. I also would like to say something very important, that some people are entertainers and some people are great entertainers. Some people are followers and some people make the path and are pioneers. I like to say Jackie Wilson was a wonderful entertainer. He's not with us anymore, but Jackie, where you are, I'd like to say I love you and thank you so much. This is one of my best friends in the world. I love Quincy Jones, and he's a wonderful producer and a wonderful person.
I'll try to make this short, but I think of 10 years ago today, being at Cedars-Sinai with my neurosurgeon fighting for me to be alive, and I'm happy he made it because this is the best present a 50-year-old could ever get. I think Michael Jackson is one of the greatest people and one of the greatest talents I've ever met, and I'd like to thank everybody I've thanked before, my family and everything else, and mainly the public that made this thing happen, and the Irish voters. Thank you.
Before we present the award for best cast show album, let me tell you about one of the shows on Broadway that's nominated in this category. A show whose music and lyrics were written by Jerry Herman, Grammy-winning composer of Hello Dolly and the score for Mame. The show he's nominated for this year, La Cage aux Folles, is not like a lot of other shows in the past. The kind with a simple plot of boy meets girl, boy loses girl, boy gets girl. Ha! This is not even close. Sugar Babies, Miss Ann Miller and Mr. Mickey Rooney.
First of all, John, we want to say, on behalf of Ann and myself, we're so thrilled to be here with all this youth, music. And thanks for letting us be a small part of it tonight. Thank you so much.
We love it. Thank you.
It's a pleasure doing the Michael Jackson show. Now, all with all of you wonderful talents out there, I just had the pleasure of meeting your star. Tonight, the nominees for the Best Cast Show Album are...
Memory, turn your face into mine. Let your memory.
Cats, Broadway cast album, Andrew Lloyd Webber album producer.
I don't want to raise.
Mannequin composer. Howard Ashman, lyrics. Sugar Babies, where was the Sugar Babies? We saw two
it
albums, and I bought
them both. That won, Cats, by Andrew Lloyd Webber, album producer, our
performer began with a rich classical background. In fact, he performed with the Chicago Symphony when he was only 11 years old. Then he turned to jazz. This year he's nominated not only for instrumental composition category, but for best R&B instrumental. With the help of some of his friends, would you please welcome Herbie Hancock and Rocket.
We'll be right back.
Performance are two gentlemen who currently are enjoying great success as a recording duo, and as songwriters they provide material that makes history for a lot of other performers. Here with a combination of 5 Grammy Awards between them are Mr. James Ingram and Mr. Michael McDonald.
There are a lot of fantastic and worthy winners in the R&B field tonight. Let's acknowledge them, right?
Absolutely. Vocal performance, female, Chaka Khan. For best R&B vocal performance, male, Billie Jean, Michael Jackson. For best R&B performance by a duo or group with vocal, Ain't Nobody, Rufus and Chaka Khan.
And now for the best R&B instrumental performance, here are the nominees. Quincy Jones and Jerry Hay, Billie Jean instrumental version.
Kashif, The Move.
Herbie Hancock, Rocket.
And James Brown, Today.
Gap Band, Where Are We Going? And the winner is Rocket, Herbie Hancock.
You know, I've been in this business 22 years, almost 23 years, and I've been nominated a few times, and this is the very first Grammy I've ever won. I'm so proud. Thank you. I'd like to thank my family, my mother and father, and my wife and daughter for putting up with me through all of the whole recording, to all of my recordings. And also I'd like to thank CBS Records, of course. And also I'd like to thank the industry as a whole for giving me a chance to do my thing, which is to make a little bit of music. Thank you very much.
His career spans four decades of music. Tennessee, back when they were originally known as the Country Cut-Ups. They have excelled in gospel, country, and pop. Through the years, they've been number one on all of those lists. This year, nominated for Best Country Vocal by a duo or group, ladies and gentlemen, the mighty Oak Ridge Boys. Take a moment, if I may, to acknowledge a gentleman who has conducted for the Grammys for the past 14 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jack Elliott and his orchestra. To present our next award are two people who come from absolutely diverse backgrounds. One grew up in a coal mining town in Nova Scotia, began her career on a folk music television show, and earned 4 Grammys as a pop and country recording artist, one of them earlier tonight. The other, reared in the farmlands of Indiana, became a top studio singer of radio and television commercials, and today is one of country music's leading female soloists. Friends, here are Miss Ann Murray and Miss Janie Fricke.
Give out the next award. Let's congratulate all of those who have already won Grammys in the country music field before we ever went on the air.
Okay, for Best Country Vocal Performance Male and Best Country Vocal Performance Female, the winners are IOU, Lee Greenwood. And a little good news, Ann Murray.
Yours truly. For best,
thank you very much.
For best country instrumental performance, Fireball, The New South.
My House, Mike Reed, songwriter.
And now for the best country performance by a duo or group with vocal, here are the nominees. I want to sing. Yokeridge Boys, American Made. Brothers Band, Houston means I'm one day closer to you.
Earl Haggard and Willie Nelson, Poncho and Lefty.
Willie Nelson and Waylon Jennings, Take It to the Limit. And the award goes to... Help me, Ann. The Closer You Get, Alabama.
We'd like to thank all the fans again for helping Alabama through another year, and thank Mama and Sally and Josh at home tonight, because 2 weeks, I'll be home in the morning. We love you.
Thank you.
Thank y'all.
The Recording Academy is always...
Oh, yeah.
Floyd. Our next presenters have helped Latin music take a giant step forward. They've played 10 sold-out days at Radio City Music Hall. They were practically mobbed when they played Los Angeles. They show signs of becoming the first major Latin group to become pop stars in America. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, Floyd, please welcome Menudo.
Yeah!
We are honored to announce the Grammy Award winners earlier this evening in Latin music. They are... Me enamore, Jose Feliciano, for Best Latin Pop Performance.
On Broadway, Tito Puente, Best Tropical Latin Performance.
A Selma, Los Lobos, Best Mexican-American Performance. We may be Latin, but we're still kids. So, we are pleased to present the nominations for Best Recording for Children. They are...
Born to Add, Album.
The Sesame Street Puppets. Christopher Cerf, Producer, Jim Henson, Muppets, Creator.
Born to Add, Track.
Bruce Stringbean and the Sesame Street Band. Christopher Cerf, Producer, Jim Henson, Muppets, Creator.
E.T. the Extraterrestrial.
Michael Jackson, narration and vocals. Quincy Jones, album producer.
The Music... The Music Machine, Part 2.
Tony Salerno, Fletch, Willie, and Ron Kruger, producers.
Rocky Mountain Holiday.
John Denver and the Muppets. Jim Henson, Muppet Theater. Milt Acoon. Barney Wyckoff, producers. Right. And the winner is... E.T., the extraterrestrial, Michael Jackson, Quincy Jones, album producer.
One of the most, it took us 3 months to make the album Thriller, and one of the most dangerous joint decisions that Michael and I made was to accept to do an album for Steven Spielberg on the storybook album of E.T. And for that, we'd like to thank Bill Kotzwinkel, the co-writers of the script, Steven Spielberg, my wife Peggy, John Williams for the score, Bruce Swedeen, Bruce Cannon, Matt Borger, George Isaki, the actors and the crew of the film, Melissa Matheson for giving us this creation, Rod Temperton, Alan Marilyn Bergman for the great song that they did for Michael, Jeremy Lubbock for the arrangement, and I don't thank the people that stopped this record from coming out. I thank Michael Jackson, who gave every pound of blood he had as one of the greatest performers to put up with the hours and everything it took for this, and for Steven Spielberg, who has been a great source of inspiration, one of the greatest sources of inspiration for my life. Thank you.
Of all the awards I've gotten, I'm most proud of this one, honestly. And because I think children are a great inspiration, and this album is not for children, it's for everyone. And I'm so happy and I'm so proud, and I just say thank you so much.
The 26th, this portion of the 26th.
A bit of confusion for our television audience, folks. Live shows. The winner of the Best Broadway Cast Album, Show Album, was Cats. So you know. It's always good to see fairy tale-like stories come true in our business. This lady graduated from the Royal Scottish Academy of Music and Drama in 1979, and she immediately signed a recording contract, which resulted in a Grammy for Best New Artist of 1981. Here's the fourth nominee for Best Female Pop Vocal, Miss Sheena Easton.
I wanna tell you what I'm going through.
the fifth of our nominees for Best Pop Female Vocal Performance. What a feeling! Here is Irene Cara. Presenters are gifted singers and musicians who create music that captures the mood and tempo of the times in which we live. She with Fleetwood Mac and on her own, and he is the leading light of the hard-driving Detroit rock sound. They are Miss Christine McVie and Mr. Bob Seger.
Before we present the annual for Best Female Pop Vocal Performance, why don't we take this moment to congratulate Every Breath You Take by the Police, for Best Pop Performance by a Duo Group with Vocal, and Being With You, George Benson, for Best Pop Instrumental Performance.
And now the nominees for Best Pop Vocal Performance Female. Irene Cara for Flashdance, What a Feeling.
Donna Summer, She Works Hard for the Money.
Gina Easton for Telephone, Long Distance Love Affair.
Bonnie Tyler for Total Eclipse of the Heart.
Linda Ronstadt for What's New. And the winner is... Flashdance, What a Feeling, Irene Cara. We'll be right back.
Are you sure? I can't believe this. God, thank you. To all the voters, to the directors and producers of the film, to all the musicians who played on the record, Richie Zito, Arthur Barrow, Sylvester, all the singers, Stephanie Sprewer is here tonight, of course, Georgia Moroder and Keith Forsey, my manager, Selma Rubin, my mother and father, who started it all for me many years ago. You know, I can't visit them if I don't say that. God. All the folks, all my close friends, who I love dearly. All the wonderful friends of mine and colleagues back home in New York who helped me become a recording artist, you know, when I was a bratty little kid hanging out back in the studios, watching them sing on mic and helping me become a recording artist. I love you all. Thank you.
Nominated for Best Pop Vocal Performance Male.
Lionel Richie for All Night Long.
Michael Zambello for Maniac. Prince for 1999.
Michael Jackson for Thriller.
And the winner is Michael Jackson.
When something like this happens, you want those who are very dear to you up here with you. I'd like to ask for my sister, LaToya and Janet, please come up. My sister Janet as well, come up. First of all, I like to thank God who's Reeve, I'd like to have you up here too, you know. Also, I'd like to thank my mother and father who were with us all the way. I mean, my mother's very shy. She's like me. She won't come up. My other sister. I have three sisters. Also, I'd like to thank all my brothers who I love very dearly. All of, including Jermaine. I forgot to thank Steven Spielberg on the E.T. album. I love him very much. And I also forgot to thank Quincy's wife, Peggy, help on the E.T. album. I made a deal with myself. If I win one more award, which is this award, which is 7, which is a record, I would take off my glasses. I don't want to take them off, really, but... Okay, well, Katharine Hepburn, who is a dear friend of mine, she told me I should, and I'm doing it for her, okay? And the girl, and the girls in the back. And...
Last award of the evening, and to present it, two recording stars who together epitomize artistry, talent, and excitement. She is last year's Grammy Award winner as Best Pop Female Vocal Performer. He has been selling out concerts around the world with the ease usually accorded the hottest rock groups. Ladies and gentlemen, Melissa Manchester and Julio Iglesias.
And now is the end. And for record of the year, our goal to the artists and producers. The nominations are All Night Long by Lionel Richie, James Anthony Carmichael and Lionel Richie producers.
Beat It by Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson and Quincy Jones producers.
Every Breath You Take by The Police. The Police and Hugh Padden producers.
Flashdance, What a Feeling by Irene Cara, Giorgio Moroder producer.
And Maniac by Michael Cimbello, Phil Ramone producer. And now is the time.
Yes, the record of the year is, she said, Beat It, Michael Jackson.
I love all the girls in the balcony. Again, thank you, my mother and father. Thank you, Epic Records Promotion Department, Walter Yetnikoff. Thank the disc jockeys for playing the records. Thanks to the public. I love you all. Thank you.
Well, big and short, and I'd like to thank Michael again, who I've told you how I feel about him before, and it's a long, continuing relationship, and Eddie Van Halen, and Bruce Swedeen, all the people I thanked before, and Freddie and Ron, the Sinclair, my wife, Don Landy, Bruce, the public, MTV, everybody. Thank you. I love you.
I'd like to thank Lionel Richie, who is here tonight, and he's a wonderful person and a wonderful songwriter. I've been knowing him ever since I was 10 years old. Also, I'd like to thank again Quincy Jones. And the fans in the balcony.
I'd like to thank my family from Seattle.
Music speaks in every language, and it dances to the heartbeat of us all. It was music brought us together. Perhaps the music that we are privileged to share can bring the people of our world a little closer to one another. Good night, everybody. God bless us all.
This is Dan Rather, hoping you'll join us in New Hampshire for CBS News coverage of the New Hampshire primary tonight, following the late news.